In the previous video, we removed the hard disk out of the TV hard disk recorder that we found on the street. And in this video, we're gonna take a look what's on it and if we can access the data. We're also gonna install my brand new OS called Winix 12. And we're gonna do all the partitionings and all the stuff that you need to do to get a drive like this ready to run in a PC. Good morning, it's kind of early, so I did not save or do anything to look good on cam. But it's not about me, it's about this hard disk that we found in that little box on the street. And I even made a better picture for you to really see that it's a 320 gigabytes drive. But now we want to see what's on it. So what will we need to find out what's on this drive? I've been thinking about the whole thing, and I think that probably this drive is using some crazy format that we won't be able to access the drive. We will be able to access it, but it will not show up in the Finder, I think. But let's try it out. So I have a little board here, and this is a SATA board. Let me bring you a bit closer. Okay, so here is a very old board that I still had, and I use it to find out, or to sometimes use an external drive onto some machine. Okay, of course this thing as well had some casing where it was kind of sitting into. And that thing I have up here, but I don't use it because it's kind of annoying. So I also have the cable that goes along with it, and here you can see this is a micro USB. I mean this is a mini USB. It's not the same as micro USB. Let me show you the difference immediately. I can find one really fast. Oh, here is one. You see, this is micro, the one that we put in our Samsung, and this we used to put in our smartphones way back in 2005 2003. Our first smartphones, these came, they came with, well, I think 2005 I got started using micro USB when I got my first SPV C500. All right. So it's of course about what's on the drive. So we're gonna connect it to my Linux computer to find the OS. Here it is. Okay. And let's go ahead and connect it. Hey. It's not on, so we must turn it on. And there we go. I feel that it's spinning, it's vibrating. So that means the thing is alive. Where shall I put it? Let's put it here. Like this. Okay. So let's see what's gonna happen. It's not showing up in the main screen, but I have a special tool for that. Oh gosh, now I cannot see where I'm clicking. I'm just gonna put this aside, okay? We all know that it's the drive that is connected to the machine. Okay. So let's boot up Gparted. I'm testing a new flight simulator distro that I created. Maybe I will release it today. This one is very good. So this is Gparted. So we're gonna look in devices, and I see that it's mounted. I see a drive from 298 gigabyte. Okay. So yeah, there is the drive. Now I see why it's not popping up. This thing has a GFS partition. It has use. It's not even showing how much is used and how much is not used. So it's impossible to unable to read the content of this file system. Because of this, some operations may be unavailable. The cause might be a missing software package. Yeah. So this is a crazy partition. A GFS partition. Format to, I don't even see GFS. So what we're gonna do here, we're gonna make this thing usable for a computer. I'm just gonna delete this partition. I'm gonna delete this one, and then we have one, and we're gonna, we first gonna update these steps. Okay, close. There you go, a very beautiful hard disk, completely free. I mean, like, then you're really stupid, right? If you're gonna throw away your hard disk recorder, just gonna put it on the street because probably, I don't know what, you changed provider. So we're just gonna create one new partition. And the partition size will be 50 gigabytes. About 55. Oh, that's a nice number. Only fives. Okay. Only fives bring beautiful eyes. So we're gonna hit one, and there we're gonna create another one. New. This one as well, 50. I want that same number, 55. It's not coming anymore. Okay, that's fine. And we add it, and then we add one more. These will all be distributions that I'm gonna create. On this day, I'm not gonna give this drive away. I changed my mind. I'm gonna keep it, because this drive was never used as a computer drive. So it's still very good. You understand? It only hosted some stupid videos. Okay, so here we have one of 80 gigabytes. This one we can make two of 40. You cannot create more than four partitions. Okay, then I learned something again. So I cannot create, why not? How you mean I cannot create more than four partitions? You really say that? It's not possible to create more than four primary partitions. If you want more partitions, you should first create an extended partition. Such a partition contain other partitions. Because, okay, I got it. So then this one, we're gonna delete. And then, this one we as well gonna delete. And from this we create a new, and this one will be half, like this, at, you see that? And then we can create one more, new, and that's it, fine. Okay, allocated space, 3 megabytes, I don't know for what that is. We cannot delete. No. What is this allocated space? I don't like it. Let's first, it's not possible to create, I know. Device, let's just update all these settings. Yes, I want to update. This looks good. Let me see what I have here. Almost there. This is going good. We're doing this as well from a USB stick. The operating system is installed on the USB stick. It's running from this stick here. See that? Okay. Everything was completed. So now we have a fine drive that we can use to install all sorts of operating systems onto, at least 4. Okay, so that's just amazing. So let's now see if it all works as expected. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna grab one of my distros and then we're gonna go ahead and install it onto the drive. Okido, welcome back. I just got one of my distros that you did not see yet. And I created this a while ago. Oh, what is this? Oh no, I didn't want you. Anything, so I don't need this. This is only when I'm gonna build the Ubuntu or some OS. So reboot again, F9. I'm gonna boot up from the TDK. Oh no, the Lexar. There we go. And this is Linux. X64, Linux 12. This is Linux 12, my man. I think with Android built in. There you go. Linux booting up. There you go. Oh, this is the incredible edition, peeps. I did not release this yet. I will only release this for special people. Not everybody will get this from me. Okay, because I worked very long on this. And I'm not just gonna put it out there for, you know, people that don't even give a crap. Wonderful. Did you hear that? That was one of my first. Oh, there it is. Beautiful Linux. You see that? So I want to install this to one of the partitions. So I'm just gonna start the installer. Microsoft never made a system like this. A system that greeted the users, huh? Make the users feel special. Only on channel 48, peeps. You know how it goes, huh? System install. So this will be Linux 12. Yep, we are at 12 already, guys. Password will be. Username to log in, studio, password. Hostname, I'm home. So, let's see. So we have all these partitions here. Now we must take very, very good look. So these are the partitions that we created. Yeah, 50-50. You see them here? I recognize them. So I'm just going to grab the first one. And then, I must unmount it first. I'm first going to unmount it. And now I'm going to mount it as root. X4, format. S'il vous plaît. That is done. Transfer user configuration data files. And then we just hit next. That's how simple you install these distros. You know, no need for all sorts of crazy things. And now the system will be installed in about 10 minutes. When this is installed, we're gonna reboot the system. And then we're gonna choose to boot from the first external drive. The first partition. Okay, we're almost there, dames y caballeros. And then we're gonna see if this all worked on this beautiful free hard disk that we found. And there you can see the system is installed. It took a bit longer than normal, but then again, it's doing this all to the SATA drive. So let's see if it all went good and if this thing is gonna boot anyhow. Let's reboot. Restart. Madame et monsieur. The thing is not even saying goodbye. Hit F9. And now we're gonna boot from the USB. No? From the USB hard drive. Eh? Wait a minute. Okay, this thing is not popping up. I see only wrong drives. I'm gonna remove these and these. I'm gonna reboot again. F9. Okay, there it is. No. USB storage drive. That one there. There you go, baby. There you go. It's now doing it all from here. See the little light here blinking? Let's see if it's gonna boot. Winx! Yay! We just installed. It's making my thing look so bad. Camera. These things can never show it correctly. Always have too much light and stupidness. So we're booting from external drive. The external free drive that we found in the, what was it again? Motorola, the VP 1963. Jawel. Let me see if it all will show good. The start button will not show good. Oh, hello. No, I forgot my password. This must be it. You see, the wallpaper is not popping up. Oh, there it is. But the start button is not pop. Oh, it came. Wow, amazing. I underestimated my skills. So this all went right. You see that? Beautiful 64-bit system installed to the internal, to the external drive. And it all works. Works fine. Amazing. So I'm happy to see this. If you think this distro is nice and you want it to, well, then you must hit me a little email, you know, just hit me a little mail, and then I might put it up, okay? I might put it up, if you ask friendly. Okay, I just set it up my system, and here it is, up and running, straight from this little drive that we found in the box, the TV box or whatever it was, and I just installed this beautiful operating system, and now I'm gonna play a little game. It's called Bulldash. At least it's almost like Bulldash. It's called Rocks and Diamonds. So I want to thank you for watching, and then I'm gonna see you in my next video again. What should I do now? Oh, this is crazy. This is so hard. Oh, I always miss these little stupid keys. It's unbelievable, this game. I love it so very much. You must walk, just walk, and then the... Oh, there we go. You see that? And then... what should we do here? Go up now. Some explosion should find place. 1, 2, 3. Oh, you see that? There's a little explosion. But how are we gonna get to this? Oh, we can get these. Oh, amazing. These are all diamonds, you see that? We used to play this game on the Atari. No diamonds. Okay, here I should let something happen. We go there. Oh, I missed those. I'm going to the next level. Come back, where am I? Oh, this is crazy. Got it. And then we need to go on a, like this. Oh, yeah. Oh, look at all these diamonds. Oh, I like. Ah! Enough.